Hi, Hein, DIY Van here, and today I'm going to go over a couple little details on the Lemans vents. These have become very popular. They're kind of cool because they're super low profile. We've actually introduced a new tall tower for the Transit that'll let you put these vents underneath solar panels. So there's quite a bit of interest in these, and we're selling quite a few of them. Basically, they come in black and white. They got an internal louver. It's automatic. It has a little wax solenoid here that when you turn it on, these open up. It's not like a click-click solenoid. It just opens up kind of slowly, so you have to be patient for that. We just introduced our control panel, so this actually goes under the louver against the ceiling. It has an on-off switch for it, which is going to open the louver. It has a reversing switch that's going to reverse and turn on and off the fan itself. It has a speed control, all pre-wired and ready for you to install. We also have a version that goes in a wall, so if you wanted to mount it completely separate of the louvers in a wall, that's another option, and it's basically the same functionality as this one. It's just mounted in a different location. The Lemans vent, it obviously has a flange that goes against the roof. We make adapters for those, so when you order a Lemans vent from us with an adapter, you're going to get an adapter that fits the contour of your roof. And then also a backing ring that goes on the inside of the van. So the one that goes on the outside of the van is going to fit the outside of the roof, and the one that goes on the inside of the roof fits the inside of the roof. So there's a slight difference between those. Some people get them out of the box and they don't really see the difference. But if you look closely, one will fit the outside and one goes on the inside. So you bond those in, and then the flange goes on. The Lemans vents come with an O-ring. We typically don't use the O-ring. We just use butyl tape against the flange, between the flange or adapter. One other thing, because of the way these work, they don't have a closing lid. So not like a max air fan where the lid closes against against the flange on top of the roof. The air closure is on the inside of the van. So this is the louvers that actually prevent air from it flowing in and out. So the vent on top of the roof is actually open. And obviously that's somewhat of an issue if you have bugs, or there's been some cases where we've, you know, in extreme rain situations or when you're driving, you might have a little bit of water come in. It's not like a torrent of water, but it's definitely something we want to address. So Lemans makes a snow filter, and we might be stocking those in the future, but in the meantime, we're going to be putting our own snow filter with it. And so today I just wanted to show you how to go about installing those, because there's a little bit of effort involved, a little bit of DIY. So in the future, we're going to, any new Lemans vents, or if you have one already that you want to have, add the snow filter to that we have, just let us know and we can send you out this piece. And now I'm going to show you how to install it. So this is the flange that goes on top of the vent, and you can see right here, I've already got this flange, the snow filter's on there. So let me just go through the steps quickly on how to do that. Got my trusty 3M spray adhesive. This is the 3M90, high strength, high temp. And you know, normally I'm a pretty good aim with this stuff, but some people don't have that ability. So I'm masked off the part that I'm gonna spray on the top of the flange. So I'm just gonna spray some adhesive around on top of the flange. So I'm going to coat the whole top of that flange that's going to be underneath the cover. And then here's my filter, snow filter. And this also keeps bugs out. It does reduce the flow of the fan, obviously. This is an open cell foam, so it does let air through, but it's going to reduce the airflow somewhat. So I'm just going to lay a bead on this. On the one surface. Okay, now I gotta let that get, this is a contact cement, so I'm gonna wave it around a little bit so that it dries and gets sticky. And I can take my tape off. Put that aside. People often ask me, you know, when they go to install Thinsulate in their vans, like, how many cans of 3M90? I'm like, you should get a lot, because this stuff is super handy for doing all kinds of van stuff. Like, you're doing some upholstery, or, you know, sticking Thinsulate, or doing something like this, then for sure the 3M90 comes in handy. So yeah, not a bad thing to have around just extra cans. I mean, if I think about how many van projects I've worked on, I've probably gone through 1,000 cans of that 3M90. I use it for a lot of things. You can use it to stick together, and it is sticky, as you can see. You can use it to stick together a mini cell for doing an insulated battery box. Okay, so now I'm just gonna lay this foam so that the inside of it is right by the edge of the inside of this louvers, or this circumference here, sorry. And I'm gonna stick it down, and it's sticking. I'm just laying it around that inside, because if I don't wanna have it inside here, because that's where the fan is, so you don't wanna have it hitting the fan. It's a little bit long. What do I do with my scissors? Oh, sorry, I gotta go get my scissors. Back with my trusty scissors. So we're gonna send you a strip. The strip is gonna be maybe a little bit long, so you're just gonna cut it off. And then you can just join like that. You don't really need to glue where it joins. It's gonna hold itself together pretty well. Okay, so that's, I put that on there. Now you can see where these are little stanchions where the cover goes on. And there's also a hole where the wire comes through for the fan itself. So we need to create a little bit of clearance for when the cover goes on. So I'm just gonna cut some V-notches at each one of these stanchions with my scissors and just pull that little piece out. So I've cut a little V-notch. Gonna do that for all of them. Not gonna cut through all the way, otherwise that doesn't kind of defeats the purpose of the filter. If you cut all the way through. You may have to tug at it a little bit. But really what I'm doing is I'm just creating clearance for that cover to come on, go on there. So I'm gonna cut about a third of the way through and just in a V, and then just pull the rest of it off. And then I want to kind of clear off the top of that so that it's going to sit, the cover's going to sit properly on there. All right. A couple more to do here. Obviously, this is going to be a little bit easier to do if it's not already on your van, but if you're up on your van, you know, you'd be kneeling on the van and taking care of it on the roof. Kind of hard to do on the from the inside out. So the last thing is, I got a place where the wire goes through, right? So that actually is closer to the inside. So on that one, I'm going to cut from the inside. Wires can go through there. It doesn't have to be precise because the wires are going to fit through there. So rather than take this one, I'm going to take this one I've already done. So that one's ready to go. This one I just made a little while ago. So, and the other thing on these Lemans fans is they come with sort of some spade connectors on there, which if you're using our speed control, I'm gonna give you new spade connectors to crimp on these wires. These, they have a plastic plug which they use, but we don't use those. We typically just snip this off and then you're gonna run it. I'm gonna give you the insulated spade connectors to put on there instead. I've used this fan to test some of those speed controls, and so I cut those off earlier. It's a little bit tricky to feed these through. There we go. A little bit of tough clearance there. All right, there we go. So now I'm ready to put the fan back on and the cover back on. Just gonna lay those so that the stanchions fit and line up. And so now you've got this filter in there all the way around, and that's gonna keep your bugs out and reduce the amount of possibility of water getting in to the fan. But it's important to also make sure that the fan isn't hitting the filter anywhere, so it's still spinning freely. And that's how you do it. So we'll be sending those out. And then all you need is some 3M90 and some scissors and a little bit of patience, and you can create a bug snow water filter for your Lemans fan. Thanks for watching. And if you need any help with this kind of stuff, we can do it for you as well.